I'm here at EsNews Boxing, back from China. Coach Brandon Krause, Ryan Mazza, you guys saw the fight?
Yeah.
Tell me your perspective on what you saw from China.
I think it's very weird outcome in that in any other circumstance, for your fighter to completely dominate the other guy for 12 rounds, you'd be nothing but ecstatic about it and looking forward to a bright future. But to me, to a guy that's followed Manny since, you know, the year 2000, it wasn't enough that he could just beat Brandon for a 12-round unanimous decision. It seemed at some point, with all his superior everything that he brought to that fight, he should have, if not stopped him, at least had some vicious rounds where he looked like that was what his intentions were to be. And I didn't see that over the course of 12 rounds. I saw a guy that was faster, that had better boxing game, decide I'm going to box and I'm going to be quicker than this guy and I'm going to punch when I want to punch. In 12 rounds from now, I'm going to be paid $10 million and it's going to be all good. I didn't see a guy, the Manny Pacquiao that we've grown to know, that is constantly searching to destroy his opponent.
But Manny won.
Yeah.
Who's next for Manny? Do you want to see Mayweather fight?
I think if I was Bob Arum, I would go after a rematch with Tim Bradley. And then I think, no matter what you think, if Manny were to beat Tim Bradley in a rematch, no matter what you think Manny's chances versus Floyd would be, you'd have to say that's the next logical fight for him. So I think it's a two-fight path back to Mayweather.
I think it's the same situation in the sense that Bob Arum's gonna, you know, keep it in the house, of course, and try to go for a rematch with Bradley, I'm sure, which makes sense. Bradley got the win over Marquez, regardless of the fact that it was a split decision, but still, he beat him. In my opinion, I thought he beat him. And so, you know, there's that. Marquez, you know, still having the KO win over Pacquiao. So, and Pacquiao actually, you know, showing some boxing skills in this fight. Instead of just, you know, trying to take a punch and give some, he was actually fighting a safer fight, I guess you can say. So in that sense, it'd be interesting to see how he could do against a boxer that's slick like Tim Bradley.
What did you get?
He's feeling pretty good right now.
What did you think of the whole melee?
The whole melee?
It was exciting stuff. Our man Ellie Sickback was front and center for it, and it added the drama, I think, that was missing from the promotion.
Yeah.
And Frankie Camps, I guess, eating too much MSG in China.
And I could definitely say this, you know, it didn't seem like the fight was getting that much attention at first.
Yep.
until the melee happened.
And then after the melee happened,
I mean that was worldwide news. I mean,
it was local news all over America,
yeah,
all over the world.
It was all over, so.
I got like 6 million hits in a week.
Yeah,
because and then there was surprisingly, or not surprisingly, zero bad blood come fight time. But
I guess at the press conference they shook hands and made their apologies, of course, like, you know, a lot of sportsmen will do and a lot of good competitors will do, of course, you know, in the name of sports.
And whatever end of this melee you pick, the funniest part, of the most ironic part, is the actual actors, the actual boxers were the ones that were the cool, calm, and collected.
Well, listen, both Brandon and Manny are good people. Manny's one of the nicest people. Brandon has one of the biggest hearts, and they're competitive, and they know how to keep it professional.
They're pros, right? And when you're a pro, nobody's scared of anyone, nobody hates anyone, everybody's trying to get paid.
And boxing is the one sport that brings everyone together. I don't care what gym you are, what part of the world, everybody comes together. So I was a little surprised when Roach went that route about Mexicans and Jews. Like, that's uncalled for.
It was uncalled for, you know, none of us saw a comment, but the thing is that, you know, one thing about when people get angry, you know, they say things without thinking.
Yeah, he's looking to talk shit.
Well, he should have apologized then. Like, instead of telling the media later that he didn't say those stuff and he made up all the interpretations, like he said, oh, there's Ellie. Are you the Jewish reporter? Is that what you asked me? We saw the video on 24/7, right?
Yeah, I did. Or, you know, I saw it, you know, but it's fucked up what he did, Ellie, okay? And I didn't like what
all he has to do is just apologize and move on. Can't we all just get along?
I hear that. You know, if that's all you're asking for, is an apology.
That's it.
If that's it, then cool, right on, you know? But like life and everything else, we do have to move on.
I agree, yeah, we have to move on.
We have to move on, so.
What I saw is just some angry dude who kind of lost control of a situation, just let words start coming out of his mouth, and which, I didn't think twice of it,
which
honestly.
Angry people, drunk people, kids, they're the best at doing that, pretty much.
There you have it, right here at Outlaws. Stay tuned, FeasibleReport.com. I'm Millie Sick, back reporting.